Hi, this is Rob. I'm going to make a Facebook cover using Adobe Spark. I'm going to use the desktop version of Adobe Spark. They also have Adobe Spark for iOS apps that are identical to what you're going to see in this desktop version. To use the free online desktop version, go to spark.adobe.com. This is the main page for Adobe Spark. If you don't have Adobe ID, you can start here with this big yellow button. Then you have three different ways to log in: Facebook, Google, or sign up for free. Or you can also log in here with your Adobe ID. You do not need a Creative Cloud subscription to use Adobe Spark. If you click the sign up for free button, then it brings you to this page where you will sign up for a free Adobe ID. I have an Adobe ID, so I will sign in with my Adobe ID. Once you're in Adobe Spark, this is their start page. You can make an image for posting here at this green post circle. This is where we are going to make our Facebook cover. Or you can make a web page here at the blue circle labeled page. Or you can make a video at the orange circle labeled video. Let's click on the green post button. At the bottom is where you can choose a graphic size for a social media platform: Instagram posts, Facebook posts, Twitter, etc. Click the More Sizes button. And here we have Facebook cover. Click on Facebook cover to highlight it. If you want to have text on your Facebook cover, this is one place you can enter that text. Right under, what do you want to say? I'm going to enter my Facebook address: facebook.com/thecommonfactors. If you want to follow me on Facebook, please go to this address and follow me. Now click on the green continue button. Okay, this screen pops up with the shape of the Facebook cover on the left with a random image and random font of the text that I typed earlier: facebook.com/thecommonfactors. If you look at the upper right of the web page, you see themes. That is where we are right now. Palette, this is where you can change the color of the text. Photo, this is where you can choose the image you want to use. And text, this is where you can change the style and the font of the text. For themes, if you click on the different themes, it changes the theme of the text. Going back up to the menu in the upper right, click on Photo. This is where we can replace the photo that we want to use. Click on this Replace button here. You can upload photos from your computer. This Find Photos button will search for royalty-free images on the internet that you can use for free. If you have Creative Cloud, you can get images from your Creative Cloud, or Lightroom, or your Dropbox, or your Google Photos. I'll click on Find Photos at the beginning. For a search term, I'll type sunrise. There should be many royalty-free images of sunrises. Click the search icon on the right of your search term. Then the images show up and you just scroll down and keep scrolling until you find an image that you like or until the images run out. Some search terms will produce more images than others. Here's the image that I like because it has a lot of copy space for my text. Click on the image. Now click and hold on the image to adjust it in the editing pane. Now I want to change the style of my text, so we'll go back up to the menu in the upper right and click on Text. We have several different options to change our text. If we want to change the words, click on this Edit button. If you want to add another block of text, click on this Add Text button. If you want to delete the text, click on the Delete button. I'm going to skip this wheel for now and come back to it in a second. This Shape button adds different shapes around your text. Down here in Social, you can add a social icon next to your text. I'm going to add this Facebook icon next to my text by clicking this Facebook icon. You have three other social media icons here to choose from. I'm going to click Save. To change the font, click on this font button. I am going to look for a font that I like. Okay, I like that one, and I'll click Save. Now this wheel. This wheel will randomly change the style of your font, and you can keep going around and around until you find a style that you like. Then you click the Save button on the bottom. But I like my original font, so I will go back around to that font. I'm going to change the location of my text by clicking on it and dragging it to where I want it. If I click on the image, it will bring me to the photo editing menu. Here they have different photo filters you can apply. I'm not going to apply a filter. I'll go back up and click None. Let's go to the palette. The palette will change the colors of the text. This top palette is based on the colors of the image, so you can choose a text color that is complementary to the image. Or you can play around with any of the other color palettes below. Now I have the Facebook cover the way I want it, so I want to download the final image to my computer. To do that, press this Share button on the top center of the web page. This window pops up, and this is where you can share these images that you created as a Facebook post or on Twitter. But this one I want to download to my computer. But sometimes Adobe puts a watermark on your image, and to get rid of that watermark, Adobe wants you to share your image on Facebook or Twitter to get rid of that watermark. Click the Share Now button. Choose the type of image this is. I will choose anything in this list. Then go down and press this green Create Link button here. I'm going to choose Twitter. This window pops up. Adobe connected me to my Twitter account. I will tweet this image. You can press the Close button here, or Adobe is asking if I want to follow Adobe Spark on Twitter. I will follow. Close this window. The watermark is gone. If you go to Resize in the menu, you can now adjust this image for other social media sites. I'll go back and highlight Facebook cover. Now press the Share button again, and then press this Download button to download this Facebook cover to my computer so that I can upload it to my Facebook account later. And there it is in my Downloads page. Adobe names these images Adobe Spark 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay, that is it. That is how to make a Facebook cover using Adobe Spark. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and follow me on Facebook.